welcome to tonight's broadcast. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for liking the page and for sharing the word. Let me take this time and appreciate our parents, Apostle David and Pastor Louisa. Thank you so much for being good parents to us spiritually. Thank you for your commitment and your leadership in this ministry. We appreciate you and we pray that God will continue to use you mightily and to use you to further his kingdom. Thank you so much. Let's pray. Father, thank you this evening for your grace upon us, Lord. We open our hearts to the revelation of your word. Let your light come in, Lord. The entrance of your word brings life. It brings light, Lord. We receive your strength and your power in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's turn our Bibles to the book of John chapter 5. We're going to read verse 39 to verse 40. The Gospel of John chapter 5, verse 39 to verse 40. I'm going to read from the New Living Translation and also from the English Standard Version. I'll start with the New Living Translation. It says, "You search the scriptures because you think that they give you eternal life. But the scriptures point to me. Yet you refuse to come to me to receive this life." I'll read it again. "You search the scriptures because you think they give you eternal life. But the scriptures point to me, yet you refuse to come to me to receive this life." From the English Standard Version, it says, "You search the scriptures because you think that in them you have eternal life. And it is they that bear witness about me, yet you refuse to come to me that you may have life." These are the words of the Lord Jesus Christ. He was speaking to the Jews at that time, especially the Pharisees and the Sadducees. These people, they were always confronting Jesus. They were always opposing him. They were always questioning his authority to do miracles, his authority to do what he was doing in the temple. So here Jesus is speaking to them, saying to them, "I see you are very diligent in searching the scriptures. I see you are very diligent regarding the Torah." The Pharisees were very devoted people. They lived very disciplined and devoted people and devoted lives. They would pray three times a day. They would pray in the streets. They were always, they would have their scriptures that they put on their forehead, a big box of scriptures. They were very religious people. Now, Jesus is saying to them, "You are diligent searching the scriptures, but one thing that you don't realize is that these scriptures, they point to me." In other words, Jesus was saying to them, the scriptures that you are reading, they are talking about me. Jesus is not minimizing the importance of the scriptures. Jesus is not undermining the importance of us reading the word, spending time in the word, and knowing the word. But what he's saying is that the word apart from him, the word, the Bible apart from a relationship with Jesus is worthless. It won't profit us in anything. You are showing that the word apart from God will not be profitable in any way. So what we see here, Jesus is saying that the word will lead us. The word points us to him. The word will lead us to have a closer walk, a closer relationship with Jesus. So that anyone who reads the word and understands it, you will come to Jesus and have a relationship with him, because the word directs us to a relationship with Jesus. The word will result in us drawing near to Jesus. The word is talking about Jesus, and the word leads people to Jesus Christ. So the Pharisees, even though they were reading the scriptures, even though they were diligent, in studying the scriptures, but they were failing to see that the scriptures were talking about Jesus. the scriptures were pointing them to Jesus. It was like, you know, a road sign where you see the sign pointing you that for you to go to this place, you take this direction. So the word points us to Jesus. The word causes us to draw near to Jesus. The word makes us to have a more intimate relationship, a closer walk with Jesus Christ. The word of God will never lead us to disbelieve Jesus. The word of God will never cause us to oppose Jesus. The word of God will never lead us to doubt who Jesus is. The word of God will always lead us into faith in Jesus. Will result in faith in Jesus, will result in us being loyal to Jesus. Well, the word of God opens our eyes to who Jesus is. It reveals Jesus to us. So the Pharisees, they were failing to see that, you know what, the word of God is talking about Jesus Christ. So this is a more reason for us to embrace the word, to spend more time in the word. We see that as we spend time in the word, we'll draw near to Jesus. We'll fall more in love with Jesus. And we spend time in the word, the word draws us near to him in Jesus' name. Let's also read from the book of 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 4. I'll read first from the New Living Translation. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 4, it says, "And because of his glory and excellence, he has given us great and precious promises. These are the promises that enable you to share his divine nature and escape the world's corruption caused by human desires." I'll read it again, the second part. It says, "These are the promises that enable you to share his divine nature and escape the world's corruption caused by human desires." And from the ESV, it says, "By which he has granted to us his precious and very great promises." God has granted us, God has given us his precious and very great promises. Now, what is the purpose? He says, "So that," for the purpose that, "through them you may become partakers of the divine nature, having escaped from the corruption that is in the world because of sinful desires." So we see that the other thing that the word of God achieves in our lives is that the word of God makes us partakers of God's divine nature. So the promises that God has given us, when we take them, when we read the word, when we put our faith in him, they transform us, they transform our nature, they transform our character, they transform the way we think, they transform, they change the way we see things, the way we do things. They make us to share in God's very nature. So the word of God will make us have the faith of God. The word of God will result in us having been, give us the ability to forgive the way God forgives, to love the way God loves, to see things the way God sees them. So we see that, you know, the word of God is very important in our life, that the promises that God has given us is because God has given us his word, which is the incorruptible seed, that when we receive the word into our lives, when we confess the word of God, when we allow the seed of the word of God to be planted into our hearts, that word will transform us into the nature of God. It will give us the God kind of life. Like Jesus said, that you think that you will have eternal life from the word, but the word points you to come to me. When you come to me, you will experience the eternal life. So we see that the word of God here, it transforms our nature. It transforms the way we see things. But now we'll see things the way God sees them. The word of God transforms our nature into the likeness of God. The word of God transforms us into the likeness of Jesus. The word of God gives us supernatural abilities. It gives us God's abilities. It enables us to act like God. to speak like God. It enables us to believe like God. It empowers us to be strengthened with God's power and might. It enables us to be fearless. The word of God makes us bold. The word of God makes us fearless like Jesus Christ. So it's the more that we need to embrace the word of God. The last part of that scripture also, we see that it is through the word of God that we escape the corruption that is in the world caused by lustful desires. We see that the Bible puts it clearly that whatever corruption, the rottenness, the decay that we see in the world, it's caused by the lustful desires. It's caused by the desires of the flesh. So the word of God will also keep us from decay. It will keep us from corruption. It will keep us from, conforming to the standard of the world. We see that in the world, people are living to satisfy the flesh. People are sacrificing everything to satisfy the desires of the flesh. It's all about what I drive, where I stay, what I wear. They are living for that. But the word of God will free us from living a life of illusion, the life of fulfilling the desires of the flesh. The word of God will keep us on the path of life. The word of God will free you from wrong mindsets, from wrong thinking patterns. The word of God will make you, will make me, will make us to think the way God wants us to think. It will make us to live the life that God has purposed us to live. God has purposed us to live the life of God, to be like Christ, to be conformed to his nature, to his image. And when people see us, they will see God in us. They will see Christ in us. And that is achieved through the promises that God has given us. So when you take the word, when you speak the word over your life, when you take the word and you think about it, you meditate on it, when you take the word and you listen to the word is working. The word is transforming your life. So I want to encourage you that in your car, play the word. On your phone, have the audio Bible. Play it. And as you listen to the word is active. The word is powerful. The word is working. The word is transforming you. The word is conforming you, is bringing you to be like God, to have the very nature of God. So, child of God, this is just an encouragement to say, let's surround ourselves with the word of God. The word of God will draw us near to Jesus. The word of God will make us to fall in love with Jesus. The word of God will make us partakers of God's divine nature. The word of God will free us from the desires of the flesh, from the lust of the flesh, from the corruption and the rottenness that we are seeing in the world caused by lustful desires. So I believe that this word has encouraged you to spend time in the word and to focus on God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. We thank God for this word that we received today. I believe that it has encouraged you. It has built you up. I believe that you are much stronger in faith than you were. And so let us take this word, apply it in our lives, and always remember that we are strong in Christ. So thank you so much for tuning in today, and tune in next time, even as we receive more of the word of God. God bless you.